So the next episode's going to be an all musical one with you guys singing and dancing, I hear.
Yeah, from actually season three is going to be one big musical.
Uh-huh.
So it'll be an operette.
We were thinking maybe
an operetta, sorry.
Okay.
Ballads will be sung.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't that be kind of fun after all the darkness you guys have had to go through, though?
Yeah, but yeah. I want it to be, like, rock. I want it to be, like, seven, it's, like, six, maybe it's, like, some still probably young, and like, some, I don't know, you know, the Talking Heads, we could do a rendition, no?
That would be kind of fun.
Right?
Well, I was going to ask, now, is she being driven just by revenge at this point? Is there something else going on? Has it evolved into something else?
Yeah, I think it's easy to mask it as revenge, but I don't think that that's really what it is. I think that she's just trying to find a way to repair the damage that has been done and heal herself and sort of fill this hole and this void. And Julia's journey on trying, she believes that by finding Reynard and killing him, that will give her the solace, and maybe she can get back to her. She can be whole again. You know, I think she is hopeful that it can give her some peace of mind.
Can she be hopeful without her shade?
The shade is a tricky little guy. The lines are really blurred, and it was hard to sort of, like, understand the guidelines of the shade. I even had trouble with it, so I kind of, it was sort of very open. It contradicts certain things, and then other elements it doesn't. So it's a very sort of, like, gray area. I think that apparently what it is supposed to do is sort of
at its core.
Give you a lack, yeah, at its core, give you a lack of empathy.
Right.
Or sort of skew your subconscious or your conscious even into being able to depict what the right thing to do is, what the moral thing to do is, and then like what the instantaneous thing is.
Right.
So it's sort of like, it's hard, it's tricky.
Yeah. That must be difficult to play.
Yeah.
Well, it's cool because it doesn't necessarily make one a bad person or a bad guy or like a villain, you know?
Right.
It's just a lack of regard of the people that you're affecting around you.
Right. Yeah. Well, there is so much gray in this series, which is nice. It's not black and white. There isn't heroes. Well, there's a couple villains,
but
basically
kind of.
Everybody.
I mean, we do set them up to be understood,
right,
from a broader perspective. So it is tricky. It's like, is the Beast a villain? You know, like he is at his core a little boy, like trying to stay in a place where he feels safe and doing anything he can to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like, you can't fault that necessarily. Yeah. I mean, it sucks because it's at odds with what we want.
but it doesn't make it wrong.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
I don't
see?
Know. The thing is, it's maybe.
Yeah.
Which is nice, which is true to the world that we live in right now, even.
Exactly. That must be really interesting when you get the scripts, because you're not really sure which direction any of these guys are going, right? I mean, so it must be like, oh, that's what we're doing this week. Is it really interesting every time you get to read the first draft of the scripts?
Yeah, interesting. Yeah,
yeah.
It's for sure. There are times where we've been on the phone and we're like, what? Oh, yeah. Jason's like, I'm walking laps around my apartment. I'm reading the script. Like, we're like, we got to do this. Like, it's. We never know. We never know what we're gonna get next.
Yeah, we have kind of like, you know, we have the novels that are sort of like the base of like inspiration to draw from. So a lot of that process of like reading the scripts is like, oh, okay, oh, awesome, this is that part of the book that I love, amazing, how can I invest and make this a more full experience, or as full an experience as I had as a reader, you know?
He brings the novels to set, and it's great, it's nice to be able to infuse the two. You know, even if something's not written in the script for the show, it's nice to pull from the book.
It's like a nice little backstory that you have going on.
Totally.
Well, is it possible for Quentin to be happy ever again? Or does he even know what he's searching for at this point?
His is a process of self-discovery. And, like, what does happiness mean? Like, I don't know what that means. I think he had very specific ideas of what happiness would mean. And how he would achieve that.
Mm-hmm.
And in achieving all of those steps along the way, he still found himself unhappy and unsatisfied, mostly. And so I think this season has been a journey of looking inward. And so maybe, in some way.
Maybe.
That's a good question, though, because that's like with the book's question. It's like, it's kind of like, can you ever really fully find happiness always, continuously? You know what I mean?
But because what is that? What does that mean?
Right, exactly. It's undefined.
Yeah. And if you found the happiness, how do you know you've actually found it? Because, well, anyway.
Yeah,
it's this circular thing.
It is, totally. And next up is the dragon.
Mm-hmm.
So how's that? I mean, what did you interact with on set?
Nothing
was there?
Nothing, no. We just
no
had
balls
a,
or anything?
Not even a tennis ball.
Wow.
No, it was... Well, no, we had an X on the wall, remember?
Oh, we did. We had a
scary X?
Yeah.
We had a green neon X and then a neon orange X. And
yeah, depending on where the dragon was at different points, we had to look at a certain X. But, like, at the time, the day before, shooting had been canceled because she was so sick that she couldn't do anything.
And the
Underworld
scene, we were both...
Yeah, that whole episode, I was dying of the flu. And so that whole scene, we were just trying to stand up. And not be like coughing.
Why couldn't they just give you guys time off? Seriously, come on, you have to recover.
I know, but you know, like, time is money.
Powered through it.
Yeah. Yeah, so like, I don't even remember most of that. I was like so high on Dayquil.
Uh-huh.
Just like... rubbing like oil of oregano. Like,
yeah, I heard you got an oil rub from a previous interview.
Man,
I got one of those.
Literally everyone on set had a different like remedy for this cold, so
yeah,
they were all
so
just
crazy,
like slipping me their things. So I just had so many like vitamins and oils and drugs like going
through my system.
You could have
actually gotten worse that way, though, mixing all this stuff together.
Anything.
Maybe.
It's possible.
Good homemade chicken noodle soup.
Oh, see, that's always a good remedy.
Danny made the best chicken noodle soup I've ever had in my entire life. I can't tell if maybe because I was high.
No, it was really good.
It was really
that good. Well, you have to have it when you're not high and then compare and see if it's still the same.
She sent me the recipe. Yeah.
Are you a cook?
I love to cook.
Yeah.
But I'm learning. Yeah, I grill and cook, and I like researching recipes online and you know, doing the whole thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So if there's a season 3, what do you guys hope is going to be coming up? What do you hope for your characters?
I'd like to see Julia and Quentin, you know, much as the books, maybe go on their journey, maybe with the ship.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to see it sort of follow that storyline. I'd like to see, you know, maybe more fillery and some of the aspects of that has with the talking animals and all of that stuff.
Wouldn't that be nice? Have they hinted to you at all that might be coming up?
No.
Yeah, we don't know anything.
In the dark.
Literally anything can happen.
Okay.
Yeah. When is this? I mean, there's the season ends with like a really big cliffhanger.
So we have to have a season 3. There has to be one, right?
We don't know.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
Hopefully. Just a really big
yeah.
Have you guys been keeping track of like what fans say online about the series? Do you pay attention to social media at all?
Yeah.
And what do you think about how they've been reacting to your character?
I love the love, like the positive reinforcements and like the people that have, some fans are making incredible fan art. Like they're painting pictures and like drawing us and like that's so cool.
Oh yeah.
And like you just like use your creative, I mean that's like such an honor, it's incredible. Very, very cool. Anything that like gets you going and inspires you and makes you want to create, very cool. It's very impressive.
Yeah. And the whole rape abortion storyline, I mean, there's a controversy surrounding it. Some people are interpreting it one way, that losing the shade meant, you know, something, and other people are interpreting it one way. What do you think the fact that she lost her shade immediately after that was supposed to mean to you?
Honestly, I can't judge the material.
Okay.
I can't judge what's given to me. I'm literally just the puppet from the puppeteers, you know, and I just whether or not I can understand or like agree or disagree or any of that, I kind of just have to leave my own stuff at the door and do what's on the page. So I am powerless in that sense. As far as the rape went, that was in the novels. That was to be expected. That was something that I could prepare for and was aware of. And you know, we did our best to, and it was very important to me to handle that as if it was a real rape, and mm-hmm. to be able to create a forum where people felt safe.
Right.
And, you know, teaming up with Rain and having their call center on a PSA after the episode aired. And I have had a lot of people come up and connect with me on that and say that, that they really, it helped them, or and that's all I can ask for, is like, to be able to have that forum. And, like, that meant the world to me, and that was great. For people to feel safe.
Yeah, I think a lot of the characters on the show go through pretty traumatic things and are dealing with a lot of like real world problems. And I think, especially like as performers, we're careful not to prescribe right or wrong answers. This is just, these are the experiences that these particular people had and how they are dealing with it. You know, with the rape and with depression and how it's depicted, you know, mm-hmm. it's like none of these are answers. They are just these people's journeys.
That makes total sense. Well, this last episode showed that your characters were coming back together a little bit more as friends. Are we going to see that moving forward?
Yeah, I think so. It seems that
Yay!
Way. I mean, when we get to the end,
big cheer.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we'll have an epic adventure together.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Okay, and last question. Is there any book series when you were kids that you wished you could, you know, basically be a part of? Like, as an imaginary, you know?
Yeah, we were talking about this earlier, but Peter Pan, you know, was like a big one for me. And like The Lost Boys and Never Never Land. And there's something like so fun and exciting and magical about that world, but it's also then like quite tragic when you like, take a look at it.
That's pretty amazing. Yeah, like, you know, like the pirates and I don't know, I love it. It's good.